Yesterday I mentioned the Medrash on the verse, the second verse in the Torah in Bereshis, where God says that right in the beginning the earth was astonishingly empty. Tohu, Bohu, a choshech, and darkness, apnei sahoim, upon the face of the depth. And ultimately, v'ruach alikim rachav es apnei amoim, and the spirit of Mashiach, which is hovers above the water. And we've cited the Medrash Rabbah, where it says that those four expressions of Tohu, Bohu, choshech, apnei tahom, refers to the four exiles. Tohu refers to the exile of Bavel, Vo refers to the exile of Modai, time of Achashverosh. Choshech refers to the Greeks, the Assyrians, the story of Hanukkah, and Tohoim, face of the deep, represents the present exile that we're in. I'd like to suggest a thought, how actually I think we're experiencing right now these four different types of goddesses. Tohu, which means emptiness, solitude. Bohu, confusion. Choshech, darkness. Tohom, depth. An ongoing situation that we don't seem to see the end. Friends, let's analyze a little bit what we have been experiencing the last few months. Tohu, empty, solitude. We're alone. We're living in a kind of a world where we are locked up, individually, communally. Places are closed, places are opening, more closed than opening. Red zone, yellow zone, green zone, and so on and so forth. There is a kind of a solitude. We celebrated those Yomim Tovim alone. How many of us sat alone in the sukkah? How many of us couldn't go to the synagogue? How many of us danced around the dining room table with a Torah, with a chumash in the hands instead of dancing in Simchas Torah? Although we had the lulav and the esrog in the hands, we unified symbolically all of them, but we were alone. Tohu. Vo, confusion. We certainly live in very confusing times. Not only confusing times, but choshech, dark times. Just like the Greeks at the time, they said they have the answers and they have the directions and just listen to us, we know what to direct you. One thing we realize that all those who set the rules and all those who give directions, with all due respect, they don't know at all what's going on. They're just making it up on the cuff. Arbitrary numbers, as an example, 25 people in the synagogue. What's the number 25 besides Koisevohu, the blessing, the godly blessing, which is Koy Chof Hey, which is 25. Short of that, why 25? You can have a huge building, no, only 25. What, when, where? Darkness, they're in the dark and they're leading or misleading us in the darkness. Same thing about the masks, confusion, yes, masks, no mask, it is helpful, it's not helpful. We don't know anything. To hone the depth, Tohim, which means like it's a situation that we don't seem to see the end of it. So we're living those four types of exiles at this particular moment. And maybe that's the message of God. Just like the beginning of creation was a time of Tohu, Bohu, Choshech, and Tohom, the beginning of creation was a time of confusion and of darkness and never ending, as we say over here. But God assures us, I already put in the You've, the remedy is there with Mashiach. Today, as we are living the last moments, the last nanoseconds before the final revelation of Mashiach. Yes, we're experiencing the beginning. There's a Chassidic concept, notes, trilosan, besoifan. The beginning and the end are connected. I think here we see the connection between the beginning of creation, the end purpose of creation, which is bringing godliness down into this world. Seemingly, it comes with a state of this tohu vohu, this chaos and darkness. So friends, let's hold on. Let's be reassured. Let us scream together, yes, God, we believe, we continue doing what we have to do. And any second we'll come out of this darkness, we'll see the light which is at the end of this tunnel, which is the light of Mashiach, the light of redemption. And then, no more solitude, no more confusion, clarity, purpose, unity amongst ourselves, and unity with God Himself in Yerushalayim, in the place of perfection, the place of peace, in the Beis HaMikdash.